This is section 9-1. Income deemed to accrue or arise in India. When you prepare this chart, you have to take connected page. Okay? There are 6 points. 3 points you will write on this side of page, and 3 points you will write on this side of page. So this is a huge chart. All right, you need to take connected page. You understood? All right, we will go to that chart at last of this session. Not now. There are, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. These are on page number 1. So I will zoom out only this much area, and then we will discuss about 1, 2, 3 on second page. But they are connection of same page. You understand? You will take two arrows. This is page 1 and this is page 2, and this is your division. Okay? That we will do just in while. I just wanted to conclude my first chapter, that see how many concepts we have covered from your own study material, because that's a base book that every one of you has to follow. You don't have to follow any author's book. You don't have to follow any other study material. Just follow whatever is given by your institute and you will score great marks. Okay? I'm not even saying 40-50. Great. Exemption. If you have patience to read study material given by your institute. Itni to pages padne yaar. No, seriously, it is this much only. Okay, you come to final, you will understand what is the burden of studying direct tax and all. But intermediate means this much. You read this much and few past paper, done. Exemption. At least you know what is going to come. You should be happy. You come to CA Institute. We don't know anything what is going to come in exam. I can't say this sentence there that you read this much and only you will pass. No. But your institute is generous that they ask usual equation from the study material or past examination question. Okay. So let's check. Let's keep track on the study material all the time. I guess we have discussed this line.
Yes, sir.
All right. So why taxes has to be collected? I told you it's a similar way, like sun drawing moisture from earth so that it will give you benefit in multifold in form of rain. Government is doing the same thing. They are getting moisture in form of taxes from you so that they can give you a lot of infrastructure benefits, defense, law and order, lot of benefits from the government side. That is just a given there. Then introduction, they have written introduction. We have done introduction in very much detail. Difference between direct tax, indirect tax, we have discussed this in GST lecture as well.
Yes, sir.
All right, difference in direct tax and indirect tax. Constitutional validity of income tax, yesterday only we discussed in GST. What is the constitutional validity of all laws? So this income tax law is written on entry number 82. Hello. Entry number 82 of union list. Hello.
Yes.
Of schedule 7 of article 246 of Constitution of India. And that schedule gives full power to central government to collect taxes on income other than agriculture income. Taxes on income other than
agriculture income.
That's what is written here. Entry number 82. Then who can collect tax on agriculture income, sir? State list. Entry number 46. It may come in exam. It is there in your module.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes.
MCQs. You understand? You should be concerned about MCQs and don't underestimate MCQs. MCQs are disastrous, okay, because they can cover any line from whole study material. Therefore, you need to literally read line by line, okay, if you want to score out of marks in MCQs. One or two, okay, you can live. But at least you should score 95% mark from MCQs. If it comes for 20 marks, then at least you should score 18 to 19, okay. Administrative, for direct tax who administer? CBDT. Indirect tax, CBIC, Central Board of Indirect Tax and Custom. That was old name. Sources of income tax. So what we are going to learn? Income Tax Act, latest amendments which are done by Finance Bill. Finance Bill will become Finance Act. We have discussed these things. Okay. Income Tax Rules 1962, Act 1961, we are going to discuss rules also. Then circulars and clarification given by CBDT. Whenever there is a confusion in economy, they will launch circulars and clarification. There is a website of Government of India where you can go and check the circulars. Judicial decisions are not there in our syllabus. They are in CA final, CMA final. Alright, Supreme Court and then High Court judgments. Basic principle of charging section. Section 4. Charging section, backbone. Hello. Do you see this word backbone? Alright. I discussed that there are two types of income tax rate. Yesterday we discussed normal income tax rate given in Annual Finance Act. Special income tax rates are given in Income Tax Act itself. Long term capital gain, short term capital gain. So certain things they have written. I hope you will understand it now. Assessment year concept is important because we are doing assessment in assessment year. Whatever we are doing, you are going to write exam in June 19, that June 19 falls in financial year or assessment year 19, 20. So you are going to do assessment in 19, 20, but for previous year 18, 19, that also we have discussed. It is the period of always and it will start at 1st April. Previous year is given in section 3, immediately preceding the assessment year. It may be less than 12 months possible. Less than 12 months for newly set up business and new source of income for them. For them it is from a beginning to 31st March. Beginning to 31st March. Date of incorporation to 31st March. I told you, if I incorporate business on 26th March, then 26th March to 31st March is my previous year. Okay. Then I told you there are certain people for which government cannot wait for assessment year to come. We will do assessment in previous year itself. Okay, exception to previous year rule. Previous year and assessment year rule. What is the rule? Income earned in a previous year shall be assessed in. But there are five exceptions in the rule. Alright, and those five exceptions are shipping business of non-resident, section 172. We have written that in note. Alright. Income of a person who is leaving India, Vijay Mallank, going to England, alright. On airport only income tax have authority to collect taxes. Then, income of bodies formed for short duration, those joint ventures kind of thing, JVs, alright. Person who is likely to transfer property to avoid tax, alright, to evade tax, avoid tax, and discontinuance of business. What is the speciality of this? Your previous year will become assessment year. Government is not waiting for 1920. Your assessment will be handled 1819 itself. Assessee. Just now I told you what is assessee. Definition of assessee is given under section 2.7 that you need to write today as a homework. Person. 2.11 different types of person, individual, HUF, AOP, BY and all. They have given more detailed explanation about what is HUF, what is this and that, what is company. What is Indian company? What is domestic company? Domestic company, I told you there is a difference between Indian company and?
Domestic company.
So domestic company means Indian company and foreign company which has arranged distribution of dividend in India. Foreign company which have arrangement to distribute dividend in India. That company is a domestic company, okay? Little different. Any other company is a foreign company. A company which is not a domestic company is a? So definition of foreign company is a negative in law, whereas definition of domestic company is a positive in law. Okay. Company in which public is substantially interested. So it is public limited company. Do you understand listed company?
Yes.
Where largest scale of publics are interested. Private limited company, there are two types of companies we have in income tax. Publicly held company and privately held company or closely held company. Okay, so that we will discuss in IFOS, not necessary to discuss here. AOP, BOI, local authority, AJP, and then they are asking you these questions. Okay, municipal corporation, local authority, corporation bank limited, any limited is a
company.
Okay, Amitabh Bachchan, individual, corporation, company, joint family, Ram, HUF, okay. Calcutta University, artificial juridic person, X and Y, who are legal heirs of Z, body of individual. So grandfather died, me and my brother are property owner of this. So income will be assessed as neither individual, OB individual, maybe individual, we together are body of
individual.
Okay. Sole proprietor business, mera CA firm, individual, partnership firm. Told you definition of income is given in inclusive manner and it's held in the definition. The definition I did not teach you because you will not understand now completely. When will you understand the definition? After completion of five heads. All five heads. Salary, house property, capital gain, PGBP, IFOs. Then you will understand this. Till that time, let it be there. How many heads of income you have? Five. That is written in which section? 14. You know those five heads, okay? Then you will get gross total income. How do you get gross total income? Total income of five heads, that is GTI. And from GTI, you subtract deduction of chapter 6, 80C to 80U. The final number is total income. Format we have already written in our language. Section 288A, section 288B. Rounding off in a multiple of 10 rupees. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. And for that they have given one illustration. Okay, can you see this illustration? 876 will become? Focus only on last two number. 76 will become? 80. 52 will become? 50. 38.90? 40. And 32.75 will become? Capital receipt versus revenue receipt. I told you that this thing. We have created one universe. All the revenue receipts are taxable in law except exempt under section 10. Whereas all capital receipts are not taxable in law except specifically made taxable. And in my language, I told you if a land is a source, then crop is the income. If a tree is a source, then fruit is the income. If I sell fruit, then revenue income. If I sell tree, capital income. So non-recurring in nature and all. They have written this. General knowledge, good. You should read. What is income? What is expense? They are writing. This theory I wanted to teach you. Okay? Tax planning, tax avoidance, tax evasion and tax management. I was in break, I was searching for what is left over. So this is a concept which is important at CMA final. Okay, but to understand that at CMA final, you should start understanding from CMA inter. Okay, important at that level. Here it is non-important, average concept. It's not that you should ignore this concept, because you know when I started teaching also, and the guy also came and he said, you know, the people that we actually read professional actually income tax, not to follow income tax, to break income tax. Alright, people are doing that. This is a fact, universal fact, that people are avoiding taxes, people are evading taxes. Alright, so what is the difference between planning, avoidance, evasion and management? Okay, so you must have clear cut picture in your mind. In future you should do tax planning and tax management. What should be your profile? Tax planning and tax management. What you should not do is tax evasion. You should never do in your life what is tax evasion. You may or may not do tax avoidance. Okay, it is legally right but morally incorrect. Legally right but morally incorrect, that is avoidance. This is legally incorrect and this is legally right. Legally right, legally incorrect. Legally right, legally incorrect. Extreme. Dono ke beech mein ka. Legally right, but morally incorrect. Unethical, but legally right. That is avoidance. Okay? You will easily understand planning. You can easily understand evasion. Management is simple. Whenever you earn income, you have to pay tax. Then you have to file returns on time. You have to maintain books of accounts. You have to deposit TDS on time. Hello? That is management. Management means following the law, complying the law. That is management. Management is a procedural aspect. Okay? Focus on these three. By using these three, the objective is common. Reduce tax. SEC reads income tax not to pay income tax. SEC read income tax to reduce income tax. We as a chartered accountant, cost accountant, we also read income tax to reduce income tax. Now reducing by legal mode, illegal mode, and legally right but morally wrong that more. So there are three ways through which you can reduce the tax. Which path you should choose? Ideally, legal one. That means you should always focus on tax planning. You should never do tax evasion. If you have guts to take a risk, then you can do tax avoidance. Sir, what is tax avoidance? Avoiding income tax. Okay, that means there is some loophole in law and that you are enjoying that loophole of law. You know that law is wrong. Galate. Somebody has written a wrong law. Or law is not perfect and you are enjoying that imperfection of law. You are exploiting the law. Law is there, but it's not perfect. So you are smart enough to exploit the law. Like I gave you example of Vodafone. Directly they did not enter into India. But indirectly they enter into India and indirect word was not there in India. So they were exploiting my law. So they were not evading. Vodafone company kind of Vodafone, they will not evade law. But they avoided the law. They did tax avoidance. They are calling it planning because if somebody asks me, I will say I did planning. It is avoidance from your point of view. So sometimes what happens, something is right from my angle but wrong from your angle. It happens with your parents, between you and your parent. Something which is right from your own angle is wrong from their angle. And sometimes they do something which is correct from their angle but it is incorrect from your angle. That's your perception. Okay. So Vodafone is also saying, we did not evade taxes, we did not avoid taxes, we just planned our taxes, and tax planning is legally acceptable in India. We said, no sir, it's not a tax planning, it's a tax avoidance, which is legally acceptable but morally not acceptable. Ideally, you should not have done. You did a transaction, you are doing the business in India, you have done this much big transaction, 12,000 crore, you should have paid that amount. Now, because you did not pay it on time, we are imposing 12,000 crore plus 12,000 crore penalty. Now you should get lesson from us. Hello? So whether tax avoidance is a crime or not is a disputable. But whether should you do it or not is a choice. What should you do? Planning. What you should never do? Evasion. Iska koi law mein punishment nahi hai. Iska law mein punishment hai. Already hai. Cash mein income lena. Kya hai? Bolo na. Somebody was asking how to save taxes. Take income in cash. You go from here, just go and go walk towards railway station. Okay? There are hundreds of vegetable vendors. Hundreds of shops. All of they are collecting what? Cash. Okay? Don't you think their annual income will be more than 2.5 lakh? Easily, yes or no? But are they paying tax in India? No. But we computed today, no, up to 2.5 lakh nil, then 5% and then 20%. They are not paying it. What are they doing?
Avoiding
or evasion? Cash mein le rahe, record nahi kare. Cash lena paap nahi hai. Unrecorded cash lena paap hai. You paid fees in cash. Okay, but we are giving you receipt. That is the recorded one. If I don't give you receipt, then unrecorded. Unrecorded cash is a evasion. Tomorrow, if I become farmer, okay, I will say, sir, I'm teaching this batch. 1 lakh rupees is my remuneration. Okay. I will bring 1 carat of tomato from my village for Dilip sir and say, sir, you take this 1 carat of tomato for 1 lakh. Batch I'm teaching free. That 1 lakh rupees is for this 1 carat of tomato. 2 kg tomato, 1 lakh rupees. I'm trying to show my business income as agriculture income. Why? Planning, avoidance or evasion. What am I doing?
Avoiding.
I'm evading taxes. Intentionally, it is a strategy. I'm forming a strategy. I know that if I take it as a agriculture income, it is not taxable. If I take it as a business income, it is taxable. There is no loophole in law. Law says agriculture income should show as agriculture income. Business income shall show as business income. If you show business income as agriculture income, then you are doing illegal activity. And that illegal activity will be punished. Hello?
Yes.
How to punish, sir? By imposing penalty on me. if it is intentional and if there is a guilty mind involved into it, and if I'm doing it consistently, then they may put me in imprisonment also. So there is a punishment written for evasion. Hello. Now avoiding taxes. Okay, how do we avoid taxes? Please understand. One is Vodafone example. One is Vodafone example. Yesterday only one of my office colleague called and they asked. There is one section 80G in income tax. Okay, I'll teach you in chapter 6A. 80G. All right. In that section, whenever you give donation to some institution, you get deduction in income tax because you are doing good thing, so you get deduction in income tax. But that section says there is a limit on cash received, that you cannot donate more than 2000 in cash. If you want to donate more than 2000, then it should be check or bank transfer, because we need evidence for that. Up to 2000 it can be cash. Now one guy in our office, what receipts he have brought, 1400, 1800, 1900, like this amount. None of the receipt were more than 2000. Total deduction was 22,000. Okay, somewhere around. My office colleague called me and said, will he get deduction under 80G? His opinion, that girl's opinion, accountant opinion was no, because it is more than 2000. 22,000 in cash. The guy's opinion, it is 22,000 in cash in total, but individually it is only less than. And every month I am giving 1500, 1800 to one temple or gurudwara, whatever it is. Alright. And I need donation deduction of that, because in none of the month I have given more than 2000. Now in law it is not written whether the 2000 is per day, per annum, per person, per trust. That per is not written in law. And therefore what I told you, you take 22,000 deduction, but tell him that he is avoiding tax. I did not say he is planning tax. I did not say he is doing evasion of tax. I said he is avoiding tax by this means, because he is using loophole in a law to reduce his tax liability, which is legally right, but morally wrong. Okay? You understand? That is avoidance. Okay? Government of India is quite concerned about avoidance. They are not concerned about planning. They are not concerned about evasion. They are concerned about avoidance, and therefore they have already launched GAR. Okay? Which is not in your syllabus. They have already launched in 2018 GAR. Earlier avoidance was not legally punishable. Now avoidance is also legally punishable as per GAR, and therefore lot of people are not happy with current government of India. People who understand law, they are not happy. Yesterday also I justified my logics. Whenever government is taking any hard decision, people are becoming unhappy. Obviously. So till now you were enjoying the law, there was no consequence. Now the first arrest that they are doing is to chartered accountant. They are not arresting assessee. The first inquiry that they are setting is on chartered accountant of assessee. Because if assessee is evading taxes or avoiding taxes, the gamer is not assessee. Assessee is the player. The person who is controlling the game or guiding the game is chartered accountant. Alright. So even we are responsible today for this thing. Hello? Alright. Sir, so people are avoiding tax. Yes or no? Legally they are avoiding taxes. Government has launched GAR. What is GAR, sir? General Anti-Avoidance Rule. General Anti-avoidance rule. General anti-avoidance. If you feel that you are smart, they are smarter than you. Hello? So right now, learning law and finding loophole is a risky thing. I am not saying for sure they will catch. It's like traveling in train without ticket. You understand? It's like a traveling in train without ticket. It's not that compulsory when you get down at Jogeshwari, TC will catch you. There is no certainty. Alright, 99% they may not catch because there is no TC on that day. But someday you will be caught, and when they catch you, they don't ask question only of current year. They ask question for so many years. They have power. Alright, and that's why now doing avoidance in India from 2018 is a punishable offense. Earlier it was okay. Legally right, but morally incorrect, and there was no punishment for immoral things because it's not illegal. legally right but morally wrong. And court was not able to punish you guys. Now court has power to punish you under GAR. Problem is that GAR is not in our syllabus. Okay. Again, what is the logic of sharing with you guys is that we are preparing to become something great. Alright. You should know everything about it. Alright. When you are thinking about tax evasion, you should know that there are consequences. When you are thinking about tax avoidance, you should know there are consequences. Okay. Doing this is like, it is your personal opinion. It is your personal life, whether you wanted to do it or not. Ideally, every one of you should do what? Because who is going to appoint you? Assess your department. Who is going to pay you? Department is going to pay you guys. Who will pay you? Assess. So you are not working on behalf of income tax department. Don't start feeling like, yeah, I'm income tax department. You are not income tax department. Department is there. You are opponent. You are working in a team of assessees. Therefore, you should always work for the benefit of assessee. But then that benefit should be legally and morally both right. And that legal and moral right benefit is tax planning. And by doing that, he should manage it tax. He should pay tax on time. If I am saying 20th is the due date of GST, you should pay GST before 20th or after 20th. If you pay before 20th, that is tax management. If you pay after 20th, that is tax mismanagement. Alright. I told you, my boss is like, he kills me. Alright. I'm the auditor of my company. One day I was explaining something to George, article, and I was writing on piece of paper, simple loose piece of paper, okay? And I was writing audit plan. Audit plan, you will understand when you study audit, is a kind of important document. But I was writing on simple piece of paper, this what we are going to do. And I was doing in an open environment, in office, one corner where we sit, I was doing there. I was not doing in a closed room. It is one of the most secret thing. It's not public document, first of all. So I was discussing audit plan like normal discussion. I did not even recognize my boss was standing somewhere behind me, and he went and then he called me in his cabin. And he was working on laptop, simply he had MacBook, he was working, and he just, Ram, what do you write in your invoice that you raised to us? So I thought he's also making some invoice, so he's asking me the description of services that I write. I said, oh, professional services. And he's typing only, huh? And I said, sir, oh, professional services. Then he said, okay, make it unprofessional. And he again started working. Make it? What I said, I'm providing? And just simply he said, you're not providing me professional services, you're providing me completely unprofessional services. That's an insult, yes or no? Why he has insulted me? Because he said, you were discussing audit plan of my organization outside cabin. You take my cabin if you want to discuss this type of serious matters. You are discussing audit plan. Now, in this organization, there is no threat. Nobody will do anything wrong. This organization is our organization. But this should give you lesson that when you do this with other clients, it is one of the most secret discussion that you are doing. You cannot do it that casually. This gave me a lesson. This should be with you also. Alright. When you provide services, which type of services you will provide? Thanks. Okay. It should not become unprofessional. You understood? Alright. So this is how it has to be done there. If you are there in a company, then that company should be under tax management. The company's name should not come under tax mismanagement. Sir, but I am not responsible. The chartered accountant is responsible. You are equally responsible. Everyone in the organization is responsible. Whether you take responsibility or I take responsibility, ultimately our client should not be in trouble. Hello, you are a cost accountant, I am a chartered accountant, there is company secretary also, there is advocate also. If we keep this blame game, no, it was the responsibility of CA, it was the responsibility of CS, then who will suffer? You tell me. Client will suffer, you understand? Our objective should be very simple. Client should not suffer and client should get maximum legal benefits. Legal and which are also morally right. Okay. To give those maximum benefit to the client, you should use two equipments or two tools. One is tax management and one is tax planning. All right. Client will tell you to do tax avoidance and tax evasion. You say, I don't do it. I don't do it, sir. I don't know how to do it. And even if I knew,